Elliot, you know how much I loved cruises when Rosie was small. It's such, you know, it's such a hit to the industry.
I know, and then when you think, you know, how much we're missing and all the families, you know, it's interesting, Cindy, following up on Nick's story. I know some of those stats might be a little unsettling to some, but I, for one, I'm very encouraged by that. And it's so important for these businesses. So, yeah, it's a long process. All right. The weather process underway changes. We've got a front on the way, wind going to be shifting, and the rain's going to be coming down. So in the city right now, gray skies, we had some early showers. There's a break. There's more rain on the way. Right now, the observation out of the park, 52. Wind out of the northeast at 12. Wind is going to be much more of a menace later today as well. Numbers warmer south and west. It's also pretty nice out through Babylon, 53. Cooler into parts of the Twin Forks. Cool up into Connecticut as well. Numbers compared to yesterday, it's actually warmer. But remember, that extra lift in the atmosphere will just add a little extra energy to these storms. That's why we're concerned about isolated thunderstorms. Peak heat last few days, well, yeah, now we're starting to dive down, and we're going to continue to cool first part of next week. The problem is we're going to pay the price with those winds. Right now it's through parts of the Jersey Shore, speaking of LBI, and then up closer to Monmouth County, where you see these showers pushing through, kind of these on again, off again waves of wet. Then watch what happens. More of the area, more of a break. Uh-oh, look to the west, and this organized front will fill in, and that's going to serve up the possibility of an isolated thunderstorm. Wind around the storm could be a problem, also dealing with the risk of severe weather. Not so much for us, but farther down, closer to the Gulf, where they're cleaning up from storms earlier this week, they've got another round today. Wet finish to the weekend. Pushes through. We pay the price with gusty winds overnight. And then those winds will bring back the sun. It'll be bright, but it's going to be blustery, 54. Tuesday pick of the week at 62. It is a big week. Baseball fan Vince saying, what about the Yankees? Well, you know, the Yankees, there's a slight chance of a shower. I think the best bet for wet is going to be Wednesday, but it's going to be chilly. I mean, look at this. Home opener, 105, 46 degrees. And I'm not fooling. It is going to be chilly for the Yankees with fewer fans in the stands as well. Next few days, that's what I mean. You've got that shower chance Wednesday, probably the best bet. And then we wrap it up. But look at how cold it turns Thursday into Friday. So later today, Cindy, we're going to be singing in the rain. But what if you're a student of singing? You know, we're all doing our part, trying to be socially distant and wearing masks in public. But what's it been like trying to make music during a pandemic?
It's been very challenging, especially because we have to deal with both students who are remote at home and students who are in person and still following the distancing protocols.
Jordan, how hard is it to sing on a cell phone nowhere near the group?
It's kind of difficult. I'm really sorry that I couldn't come. I'm grateful to be singing virtually.
We have to be very careful about the aerosols and airing the rooms out in between, and it's all kinds of scientific stuff that I never learned anything about in graduate school.
Sing, sing, singing in the street. Yeah, yeah, we.
How hard is it to be a soloist and make music with a mask on?
Getting those fuller, deeper breaths that I need to be able to sustain measures and sustain phrases, it's definitely difficult.
When you sing, you want to take in a lot of air, right? So it's hard.
Yeah, and you know, trying to pull the air in, you might have noticed I, you know, that too, so yeah.
Have you ever fainted singing?
Almost. No, not yet.
Wow. Would you say the challenges of this horrible pandemic is making you a better performer and singer?
I want to say yes and no, only because this is just in the way of me breathing and making sure that I sound great, but I feel like as a performer, it's just still giving me that ability to be on stage.
More people are coming in to sing because it's that emotional, social connection that music gives us.
All we need is love, love, love. All we need is love.
Isn't that lovely? And Cindy, I learned something I didn't know. They make singing masks with an extra piece of fabric down here to help you, but it is all about airflow. But they're still making music at Caldwell University. So keep a song in your heart and a mask on your face. Back to you.
John, they sounded amazing. And we could hear you sing as well. You've got a nice voice.
Thank you, Cindy. You and I, we should go on the road and do a show.
No, I'll be the MC and you can be the singer. John, thank you for sharing all that. Okay.